we do it all.
Hello, I'm Fred Lacoste. On our next Silicon Valley Business this week, a major announcement about the controversial network computer, and we'll bring you a profile of Milan Mandrake, one-time soccer mogul, today celebrating a high-tech turnaround.
Watch Silicon Valley Business this week, Sunday night at 10, and rebroadcast Monday morning at 6 on Channel 36, AICU Television.
After 20 years, 8 friends went back to camp.
This is going to be a wild week.
Woo-hoo! Indian summer.
Tuesday night at 8 on 36 KICU.
Judge Reinhold is on the way up.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you, sir.
Danny DeVito is on the way down. And Rick Moranis is on the way out.
I'm dying here! I'm dying!
In a story about nice people.
No, I can't hold!
Important jobs.
Zip this up for me.
And humble beginnings.
20 years ago, I came to this town. I had less than $43 million in my pocket.
It's all happening at the head office.
Tonight at 8 on 36 KICU. Children's Hospital of Oakland hosts its annual benefit, Silverado Concours d'Elegance, June 2nd in Napa. For more information on this and other local events, call the KICU Community Events Line.
Brian Adams here, inviting you to join me for Dialing for Dollars, weekday afternoons at 1 here on 36 KICU. You never know, you could be our next big winner.
Watch The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, weeknights at 7 and 7:30 on 36 KICU.
Get ready for High School Sports Focus Playoff Edition. Tonight, highlights from thrilling playoff games all around the Bay Area. You'll jump for joy with baseball action as we narrow the field to a final few. We'll tell you who made it to the big dance. Slide into your seat. You won't want to miss our softball action with thrilling finishes all around the Bay. Plus, the CCS track and field finals and life in the fast lane with Tisha Ponder. Sports Focus is head and shoulders above the rest. Next.
Now it's time
for Westwood High School's favorite show,
High School Sports Focus.
And here's the host, Robert Bronstein.
All right, guys, thanks. Good evening and welcome to the show. An action-packed hour for you tonight. Highlights from no fewer than 35 sporting events around the entire Bay Area, including all kinds of baseball and softball from both the CCS and NCS playoffs. And plenty of highlights from the CCS track and field finals held Thursday, including an up-close look at Del Mar's track sensation, Tisha Ponder. But we begin with baseball, NCS 2A Division quarterfinal, San Ramon Valley and St. Mary's. A nice crowd on hand, and fans were treated to a good game in this one. 3-1 Panthers in the sixth. But San Ramon's Darren Heinrich singles to center with the bases loaded. Matt John scores, and the St. Mary's lead is just 3-2. A sack fly would tie the score before back-to-back walks would untie it, the gift giving the Wolves a 4-3 lead into the seventh inning. But St. Mary's rallies. Matthew Brown comes up in a perfectly placed squeeze bunt. Puyaso, he scores, and it's tied at 4-all. Now, moments later, San Ramon uncorks the wild pitch. Here comes Miles Richardson to the plate, and he is safe. And St. Mary's comes back to steal a 5-4 win from San Ramon Valley in that one. St. Mary's awaiting the winner of Bishop O'Dowd and Cal. The two met at Logan High Tuesday night. Cal dominating this one from start to finish. Kevin Kaufman starts things off with a hit to center. It gets by the center fielder. Mike Menard scores, 1-0 Grizzlies. Third inning now, bases loaded. It's Kevin Kaufman again. He sends one to the wall, clearing the bases, 4-0. Cal Kaufman, one of the best pure hitters in the Bay Area. Cal makes it 6-0 on this play. The ball is bobbled at short. A run scores, 8-3 the final. Cal rolls on. Highlights of its matchup with St. Mary's coming up. Sports Focus Club members everywhere, including Muni Stadium Wednesday, Monterey, and Palma in the Division II semifinal. Monterey gets on the board in the second. Gus Tarantino, base hit up the middle. It gets by the center fielder. He can't believe it. Resch Bondy scores 1-0 Toreadors. Monterey ended up with four runs in the second. 6-3 now Monterey. Palma with runners on second and third. Justin Lindquist hits a rocket to left. Watch the catch. Gus Tarantino extends to make the grab and stop the Palma rally. Monterey goes on to win at 8-4, advancing to the final Saturday at Muni. That could be play of the week. We'll check and see later on. Monterey into the final against the winner of Sequoia and Carmel, and they were dancing in the aisles for this one. Carmel would prove dominant. Gary Briant with a Texas leader in the back of the infield. Aggressive running here from Matt Allen. He scores all the way from second. 4-0 Carmel in the third. Later, Coulter Bissell drives one to center. Gary Briant scores. Carmel wins it 10-2 the final. Carmel and Monterey for the Division II final Saturday at Muni. With the sectional finals just around the corner, can Logan keep the number one spot in our top 15 poll? Here is Jim Pimentel with a look at the complete list.
Hi, I'm Jim Pimentel of the Oakland Tribune with this week's Alameda Newspaper Group Sports Focus Boys Baseball Poll. Number one continues to be James Logan, followed by two St. Francis, three California, and four De La Salle. Five is Leland, followed by six San Ramon Valley, seven Wilcox, and eight Monta Vista. Encinel is number nine, followed by 10 Granada, 11 Bellarmine, and 12 Archbishop Mitty. Number 13 is Pittsburgh, followed by 14 St. Mary's, and number 15 is Sequoia. That's our baseball poll for this week. I'll be back later in the show with the softball poll. I'm Jim Pimentel.
Remember those polls done earlier in the week. Lots of changes, I'm sure, for next week. Our movie previews have returned. Coming up later in the show, Sports Focus Club members will have a chance to win passes to the upcoming screening of the movie The Arrival. 15 club members will win passes for two to the film, which stars Charlie Sheen. Stay tuned for details on how to win. Highlights from the CCS track and field finals, NCS volleyball finals, and so much more baseball and softball when we come back.
Coming up next, more baseball softball highlights.
It's like the play of the week.
I'm Benicia High's favorite show.
High school sports focus.
I saw a couple go into a 7-Eleven on a Friday night. It's a romantic date. What do you wear to eat beef jerky?
You mean I gotta put on a shirt and shoes?
Hey, 7-Eleven's changed. Y'all got a lot of new stuff in here now. Gourmet coffees, bottled waters, frozen yogurt.
What, you got women running 7-Eleven now?
7-Eleven, so many changes, it's not even funny.
Pork rinds and Perrier.
Is this heaven or what?
Back in 1945, the burgers at Clark's Charcoal Broiler were handmade from real beef patties ground right on the premises. Then charcoal flame broiled over an open fire for that real backyard barbecue taste. And today, Clark still fixes them that way. The ribs and chicken and links, too. Just the way they did over 50 years ago. And now they've opened a brand new location in Campbell. And others soon to open in Pleasanton, Menlo Park, and Burlingame. Clark's Charcoal Broiler, a generation of fabulous food.
Does Hitachi make camcorders,
yes.
Barcode readers,
yes.
Micromotors,
yes.
PBX systems,
yes.
Clown noses,
no.
Mass transit trains,
yes.
Semiconductors,
yes.
Lots of products,
lots.
Over 20,000. Yeah, but who's counting?
High School Sports Focus is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. Hitachi. Hitachi makes semiconductors and 20,000 other memorable products. And by Clark's Charcoal Broiler, home of the world-famous Clark's Burger. In Mountain View, San Jose, Campbell, and Pleasanton. Santa Clara Truck Wreckers. Big or small, we do it all. The Pepsi Cola Company, who reminds you that nothing else is a Pepsi. And by the San Jose Clash. Experience the excitement of world-class soccer. Call 408-985-GOAL. And by Fry's Electronics. Your best buys are always at Fry's. Guaranteed. And by 7-Eleven. So many changes, it's not even funny.
Thank you.
A terrific Spirit Corner turned in by the 1996-97 version of the Alhambra Spirit Squad. The group headed by Cheryl Martinez making its performing debut right here on Sports Focus tonight. We thank the girls for their fine effort. Quarterfinal action now in the CCS baseball playoffs. Bellarmine and Leland. A nice crowd on hand to see these two section powers. The Bells strike first in the first. Jack Headley grounding the single up the middle. Brian Sinceri and Thomas Disceglia score 3-0 Bells. But Leland comes right back in its half of the inning. Scott Leiser rips a shot to the wall in left center. It goes for a double. Bobby Hill and Kevin Tillman score to tie it at 3-3. Tied at 7 in the bottom of the fifth. The Chargers with two on. When Hill hits the single to center, Scott McFarland and Nick Garetas score, and it's 9-7 Leland. The Chargers put it away in the sixth. Garetas manages to get this one through the infield. Brandon Hill comes in to score, and the Chargers go on to beat the Bells 11-8 and earn a matchup with Monta Vista. Highlights of that one coming up later in the show. We stay at Powell now, but move it over to the softball fields. Monterey and Midi, CCS Division II quarterfinal, bottom of the sixth, 1-0 Midi, and the Monarchs had their lead on this perfect squeeze bunt by Nikki Stemberger. Taja Kirkwood scores 2-0. Palo Alto rallies in the seventh, two on and one out, when Natalie Fry singles to center. Buffy Lacasey scores, cutting the Midi lead to 2-1. Carolina Morales then lines this ball down the right field line. Vicki Hill will score easily as Palo Alto somehow gets the out at first, but watch the heads up. Base running by Fry. She never stops around third and slides home with the go-ahead run. Bottom of the seventh, now down 3-2. The Monarchs rally. Janice Guglielmo at second when Monica Lebron hits the drive to deep center. Guglielmo scores, and when the outfielders have trouble with the relay, Lebron comes all the way around with the winning run. Midi advances with the 4-3 win. The Monarchs advancing to play Monterey in the semifinals. The Toreadors with two on in the first. Sherry Sopko smacks a single to left. Eva Real and Lena Swanson come home, and it's 2-0 Monterey. Next up, Courtney Neff comes up to the plate. She hits a grounder past the drawn-in infield. Sopko scores, and Monterey leads it.
More than aspirin, more than I...
2-0 after one. Down 6-0 in the fifth. The Monarchs mount a comeback. Jamie Foreman-Robb with this to center, scoring one of four runs in the inning for Midi, cutting the lead to 6-4. But Liz Mosqueda would slam the door on the Monarchs. Monterey is in the Division II final. Always fierce rivalry between Burlingame and Cappuccino facing off in the CCS semifinal. Bottom one, Sarah Olson, a shot to left. The Mustangs with runners at first and second. Next batter is Erica Reynolds. She singles to right. Here comes Christina Garza. She is safe, and Cappuccino has a 1-0 lead. Now runners at second and third. Vicki Murphy, the bunt. Jen Pick fakes the throw to first, but the throw to third gets away. Olson scores. 2-0 Cap in the very first inning, and that lead would hold the entire game thanks to terrific Cap defense. Look at Garza, the sophomore center fielder, with a great sliding catch. Cap advances 2-0 over Burlingame. Back to baseball now with the Logan Colts making their bid for a North Coast section title. Tito Fuente settling in to watch his son Patrick and the rest of the Colts. Santa Rosa on the board first. The cleanup hitter Kevin Anderson goes to the fence. In right center, Jeff Narduzzi scores 1-0 Santa Rosa. Bottom three now. Logan's Oscar Vargas right, a shot on the line, right on the line over the fence and left. Alvaro Ruiz scores ahead of Vargas, 2-1. Logan with the home run. Still in the third, runners at first. Pickoff play catches the runner off first, but Rob Douglas breaks to the plate and scores. 3-1 Logan. The Colts get one more in the fourth. Riz with a drive to left center. It's a triple. He scored later on a Douglas sack fly, 4-1. Logan advances. Highlights from the Logan semifinal a little bit later on. The Colts to meet the winner of Newark Memorial and Pitt. Top of the third, the Cougars' Joe Gutierrez singles sharply to left. Matt Michael scores. Darian Wallace is gunned out at third. Nice play there. 2-0 Newark Memorial. The Pirates battle back. Mario Arias hits a shot to the wall in center field. That allows Will Shepard to come all the way around from first to score, and the lead is now just 2-1. We're tied at 3 in the bottom of the seventh. Simone Tafoya sends a shot to the opposite field. That allows Arias to score easily from second, and Pitt advances to play Logan with a 4-3 win. Highlights of that one a little bit later on in the show. The top track and field athletes from around the Central Coast gather together at San Jose City College on Thursday for the CCS Finals. A full house packing the stands for this always very popular event. We begin with the boys' 4x100 relays, always one of the most exciting races in any meet. The guys to watch in this one are the ones in yellow and brown. That's Del Mar High assuming the lead in the top of the stretch. The Dons will hold off a charge from Milpitas and St. Francis down the stretch to win the race in a time of 42 seconds flat. To the girls now, 4x100 relay and another team in yellow, this time St. Francis just overpowering in this race. And with Demetia Craig running anchor, this race not that close. St. Francis will coast in a time of 47.68. Los Gatos and Gunn finish second and third, also winning a spot in the state meet. We go now to the girls' shot put, and a huge day for Carmel's Darlene Tallulah. You see her winning the shot put with a throw of 43 feet 3 inches. Tallulah would also win the girls' discus. Back to the track now, the girls 100 meter, and all eyes on the girl in lane four. That's Demetia Craig of St. Francis High School. Of course, the daughter of Roger Craig, but you already knew that. She holds the fastest 100 in the nation this year, and she pulls away from the field to win the CCS in a time of 12.05. The boys 100 meters, a much closer race. Damon Hamm of Milpitas, Joe Navalu of Fremont, and Aaron Bryant of Wilcox taking it down to the wire before Hamm pulls it out in a win-aided time of 10.67, just 0.06 of a second faster than Navalu. Let's take a look now at some of the other results. Some of these times are wind-aided. These are the event winners. However, the top three advance to the state meet. We begin with the boys. Del Mar follows its 400 relay win with a win in the 1600 relay. Leland's Dan Sakurik won the 1600 meters. Damon Hamm of Milpitas won the 200 meters. Joe Navalu of Fremont, the 300 meter hurdles. And San Jose's Kareem Morrell captured the 800 meters. In the girls, St. Francis wins the 1600 relay, while Silver Creek's Deborah Bleich won the 1600 meter run. Demetia Craig adds to the 200 to her list of wins. Woodside's Siobhan Jennings wins the 400, and Lena Biber-Ferro of Los Gatos takes the 800 meters. And we'll have more highlights and results from that track meet a little later in the show. Tonight's high school moment comes from 49er All-Pro linebacker Ken Norton Jr. The former UCLA star grew up in Southern California and had some fond memories of his time in high school.
I tell you, high school football is special to all of us. I think that those friendships you make, and that's back in the days when you just learned how to play the game, learn how to be competitive and things like that. I think homecoming always sticks out in your mind, and cheerleaders really stick out in your mind, and it's just a lot of fun.
When we continue, we'll head out to Clark's Charcoal Broiler to meet the Antioch volleyball team and lots more baseball and softball. Stay with us.
Hey, Katie.
Hey, Marianne.
Hi. What's up, Sandy?
Hooray, won the high jump. We told you about Tallulah's shot put win, but check out that throw in the discus. Just 6 feet shorter than the boys' winner, Willie Howard, and 9 feet better than the boys' second place throw. Not bad. Finally, Mary Lou Badillo of Mount Pleasant won the girls' pole vault. Next week, highlights from the NCS track and field finals. One athlete who did very well at the CCS meet, as we mentioned, is Tisha Ponder. Tisha is an exceptional student athlete from Del Mar, and as Ted Rowland tells us in this week's Out of Bounds, she has some very lofty goals for the state meet and for her future.
Tisha Ponder is possibly the best all-around athlete to ever come out of Del Mar High School. She's also the perfect example of what a student athlete should be. Tisha won 4 events at the CCS track finals on Thursday. Now it's on to the state meet, where she hopes to accomplish the goals that she's been working towards all season.
Possibly obtain 2 state meet titles, you know, in the triple jump and the long jump, and just to set personal goals, personal marks for myself, and represent my school.
Tisha would be a great representative for any school. This fall, she'll be representing the University of Illinois, where she has received a full scholarship to compete in track and field. But her dedication goes beyond athletics. She's also got some very lofty goals in academics.
Yeah, to major in biology, and I'm not sure what I'm going to minor in, but from there on, I'd like to get a degree in medicine and pursue pediatrics.
I've had a lot of good athletes, and I've had a lot of, you know, athletes that are very intelligent, but I haven't really had one that has the combination of both.
Scott Evans has been coaching track at Del Mar for 14 years. Tisha has been a blessing, rejuvenating him and helping him to improve as a coach.
Every now and then you'll get a type of kid that'll come along and kind of give you an opportunity to coach them. For me, what it's done is it's gave me an opportunity this year to become a better coach. It's the first kid that I've ever had that's done everything that I've said verbatim without questioning and asking me, well, why are we doing that, or what's that for, I don't want to do that, you know, that type of thing. She's done everything, which has challenged me. Her talents has challenged me to go to clinics, do more reading, ask questions of other coaches. So it's kind of, as she's excelled, it's kind of helped me go to the next level as well.
Tisha has qualified to compete in a remarkable 4 individual events at state. She may decide not to run the 300 or the 100 hurdles so she can concentrate on the long and triple jump. Whatever she decides, one thing is for certain, Tisha Ponder is a fine representative not only for her school, but the state of California. For High School Sports Focus, I'm Ted Rollins.
And Tisha decided just this morning that she will, in fact, compete in all 4 of those events at the state finals next week. Good luck. From the track to the diamond, North Coast Section 2A softball action, Castro Valley and De Anza. And you know, when Jim Pimentel makes a house call, this game is big. Some nice De Anza defense early on. Watch Maria Sapola go deep into the hole. The backhand of the throw to Fuscoop nicely by Valerie Decker for the out. Bottom of the fifth, Castro Valley's Rachel McDonald lifts a fly ball to center. Nicole Frieri tags and scores. 4-2 Trojans remain that way until the seventh, when Kelly Fong Van loops the single to right. Decker scores, and all of a sudden it's 4-3. After a force out and a bunt single, Aaron Hollinen comes up and rips the single left. It gets by the left fielder, and that will clear the bases. Allison Medellin, Latrice Brooks, and Hollinen all come around to score. The Lady Dons pull out a thrilling comeback win, 7-4. De Anza awaiting the winner of Granada and Benicia. A big crowd watching Granada take the lead in the fifth. Kathy Super Cooper, the single up the middle. Jen Asbury scores, 1-0 Matadors. To the sixth now, Asbury at the plate. She singles to left. The throw goes to third. Kim Johnson scores, 2-0 Granada. Solid Granada defense holds Benicia scoreless. Steffi Silva, the spectacular sophomore, doing the job. Granada advances, 2-0 the final over Benicia. Lots more highlights still to come, including some NCS softball semifinals played Friday night. But first, a look at the schedule for the NCS and CCS baseball finals set for Saturday right here on the Pepsi Scoreboard. Tie the game. We go to the top of the seventh, game tied at 2. Sanceri up with a runner at third. She lays down the bunt. And the throw here is mishandled at first. Marcella Macias scores to give Leland a 3-2 lead. Candice Ambelang tries to close it out. The Leland pitcher gets the ground ball to second. To end it, Leland earns a spot in the finals with a 3-2 win over an awfully good Carlmont team. Well, if baseball and softball is not providing enough excitement, the NCS Volleyball Championships were also decided this week. The Class 4 final pitting De Anza High against College Prep of Oakland. Owen Roberts had a big night for Prep. Here he picks up the slam for the side out. Prep just seemed to find the right spots in this match. Jesse McFarland now on the serve. De Anza is able to return it, but Matt Hull positions himself perfectly for the block. The Dons put on quite a battle themselves. Nick Reeder times his lead perfectly for the kill. But Prep would capture the crown in 3 games. Look at the effort by McFarland here. He's blocked once by Deanna, but he gets the second chance and slams it home. College Prep, your Class 4 NCS Volleyball Champs for 1996 in 3 straight. Amador Valley and Antioch in a classic for the Class 1 final. Even the Prom put on hold for this one. Match tied at 1. Antioch bidding for the winner in game 3 with the slam, but Amador's Jeff Hemming with the excuse me dig that falls in, and the Dons win game 3. But Antioch rally some good net play here as John Tiernan says, you got to get that out of here. Antioch knocks the match at 2 games apiece. The Fams revved up for the 5th and deciding game. After trailing 10-9, the Panthers run off 5 straight points. Chad Mahaffey with this slam, and it's 14-10. But again, the Dons rally. Steve Arnold with the winner here, and the score is 14-12. But Antioch would survive. Here is match point. The return is going to be wide. Antioch takes the Class 1 final in 5 thrilling games over Amador Valley. Time to head out now to Clark's. This week, Ted Rollins is with the Antioch volleyball team. The guys are out in Pleasanton at the newest Clark's, slated to open in early June. Ted.
Okay, thanks, Robert. We are in Pleasanton at the future home of Clark. You know, Pleasanton on Main Street, it's a beautiful place for restaurants. They're all along there. But in a couple weeks, in mid-June, this place will really become a culinary mecca when Clark's Charcoal Broiler opens up for business. With us tonight are the guys from Antioch, the volleyball team. They are the NCS champs. Welcome, guys, to Clark's. A very happy group. Antioch had an unbelievable season. Undefeated in league for the second year in a row. They came from behind to beat Amador Valley. Chad Mahaffey's a senior on this team. Chad, you guys were down early in that one, but you came back. Take us through it.
Yeah, we won the first game pretty easily, and I think we kind of let it get to our heads a little bit. And second game was really close. We lost by a couple points. And then third game, we kind of let ourselves, you know, get into it a little bit, kind of let ourselves get down on each other. And we went in.
Were you worried at all?
A little bit, yeah. Went into the locker room after the third game, before the fourth game, and just kind of talked to each other, you know, picked up each other. We came out the fourth game and picked it up a lot, played as a team, as a unit, and won the fifth game.
He ended up winning the whole thing. This is Don Harris. He is a 4.0 student, and, you know, the team grade point average is over 3.0. It's about a 3.3. Don was our Scholar Athlete of the Week last week. Don, congratulations to you on the championship. What about this team? You guys were down in that game, but you came back. Was that kind of the character of this team, and was that indicative of how the season went?
Yeah, I think all year long we kind of played up and down. We kind of rose to the occasion when we had to. Sometimes we, like, our two losses, that's when we really weren't playing our best. But I think we came up this last game, rose to the occasion after being down two games, and we kind of turned it on.
USC next year, you're going to play volleyball? You're going to play any sports? You're going to play volleyball?
Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully, I'm trying to walk around.
4.0, though, he can do anything he wants. He's the man. All right, there's a shot of the trophy. Yes, 2 years in a row, Antioch has won the North Coast section, and their coach for the third year now is Lou Panzella. Volleyball in Northern California, is it on the rise?
I think it's on the rise. 3 years ago, there were about 40 high school teams for boys. Now there's about 60. It's growing in popularity. I think anybody was at the match Saturday night that saw that match, if they didn't walk out of the gym a volleyball fan, they don't like sports. Every year we've seen crowds getting larger at the games, and I think it's definitely on the rise. We're not at Southern California yet, but we'll be there in a couple of years.
And Antioch will be back again next year. Guys, thanks a lot for coming down. We're out of time. Clark's Charcoal Broiler in Pleasanton, it'll be open soon. These are the guys from Antioch, the NCS champions. Robert, back to you.
All right, Ted, thanks. A thrilling baseball game played Tuesday between Alhambra and Encinal. Say hi to the fans at San Leandro Ballpark. They saw two terrific pitchers, Roland Richard tossing for the Jets. For Alhambra, Kevin Toms pitching very well. Scoreless to the sixth inning. Sean Onstott up at the plate. He goes deep to the fence and left. Vino Jackson scores 1-0. Alhambra has the lead. Bottom six and the Jets tie it up. The grounder to third, one out at second. Over to first, it gets away, the run scores, Antoine Rollins scoring, and we're tied at one all. Bottom seven, great play here by Toms. A dribbler toward third, Toms fakes the throw to first, goes to third, and gets the second out of the inning. Heads up play there. But Richard steals second, then this Brian Petroni shot up the middle, stopped by the shortstop. Coach Jim Saunders says, Roland, get going or I'm gonna beat you to the plate. The throw is just late, Richard scores, and Tanal wins a thriller. 2-1 is the final, and they were pretty happy about it. Granada and Moreau at Logan for the NCS Division 2A quarterfinal. A hazy afternoon, bottom one. Granada gets on the board. Corrigan Willis hits one to the wall in left center. Ryan Abramson scores from first, 1-0 Matadors. Didn't take long for Moreau to come back. Top two, Brandon Craver finds the gap in left center. The ball rolls to the wall. LJ Shea scores. Craver is on second with the double. Third inning, game tied at one. Runners on first and second. Vince McCrary with a base hit to center field. The ball gets away. John Panicchio scores to give Moreau a 2-1 lead. Still in the third. Another hit up the middle. This one from Jared Bordy. Two runs come across. It's now 4-1 Mariners. Great defense here. Watch the shortstop. Craver knocks it down and starts the double play. Terrific effort here. Possible play of the week. What do you think? We may see that later. 4-1 Moreau in the seventh. Granada with a last chance. Vince McCrary singles to center, bringing home another run. It's 4-2. Tying run at first. The Mariner defense comes through, though. 6-4-3 double play to end the game. Moreau wins 4-2. The final. And we'll have the highlights of Moreau's next game coming up. Our Paramount's Great America All-American Athlete this week comes from Sacred Heart Cathedral High School. She is track and field star Camila Williams. Just Thursday night, Camellia qualified for the state meet in the girls' 400-meter run. Not only does she excel on the track, but in the class as well. She holds a 3.5 grade point average for her work. Camellia received a free pass for her and her teammates to Paramount's Great America. If you're a coach and have someone deserving of this honor, send us the info at this address. Our next winner comes next week, and that's your last chance to have it done. Let's take time out to honor the creators of this week's art wall. Tonight's work comes from the talented students at Archbishop Mitty High School. Shannon Osar, your primary artist on the project, but she had lots of help from the likes of Janelle Smith, Maureen Holt, and Katie Orishtian. All are members of Peggy Lemack's art class. And as we dissolve back here to the studio, a look at the final project. We thank the Monarchs for helping dress up our set tonight. A job well done. Let's head out to the doctor's office now and meet with sports physician Dr. Arthur Ting. Tonight, the good doctor talks about hamstring injuries.
The High School Sports Health Tip of the Week is brought to you by 24-Hour Nautilus Fitness Centers, now with over 100 locations for all your fitness needs. And by Sport West Physical Therapy in Los Altos and Sunnyvale, and Solutions Physical Therapy with two locations in Fremont. Your partners in rehab, working together to get you back in the game.
Hi, my name is Ronnie DiMaggio from Sarah High School, and I would like to ask Dr. Ting, how do track athletes prevent hamstring injuries?
The hamstrings are a group of muscles in the back of the leg that are responsible for basically hip extension, which is used in running and jumping. Okay, these are the muscles that we depend upon and put a lot of stress on, and that's what makes them real vulnerable to injury. So one of the key things that you have to do to maintain the flexibility of these muscles before you run or jump or participate in competition is to maintain the excursion of the muscles by maintaining a good stretch and good blood flow to the area so that injury can't occur.
Get your waistline in line at 24-Hour Nautilus Fitness Centers and get ready for some